So firstly, we are able to achieve one success through our channel. We recently made a video about Ola electric scooter dealership scam. Some person started a fake website and asking money who are interested in Ola electric scooter dealership, and that we have forwarded to Ola electric team, and they have replied to that it is a complete fake website and we never opened for dealerships or distributorship. That's what they replied. After uploading this video, the fraudster has deleted the website, and you can see that the website is right now not accessible. Such kind of scams are happening everywhere, so definitely people need to be a little cautious while applying for dealerships or buying electric vehicle from unknown companies. So viewers, if you want to share your local electric vehicle news with us, please join our Telegram group, and we will provide the link in the description below. So welcome back to Electric Vehicles channel, my dear friends. I'm Krishna Chaitanya Mandela. In this Ask Electric Vehicles episode, I will answer some of the subscribers' questions. And the first question is asked by Mr. Himanshu Gupta. Which is better scooter, Ola or Hero Optima HX dual battery? See, you can take this simple example. Consider a smartphone, mobile phone. For your requirement is mostly of charging. For you need 6 hours of charging time or 10 hours. You need more battery backup. And other cases you want to use for gaming purpose, you need good RAM, for example 6 GB of RAM. So both are different criteria. In the same way, your question is also whether to go for Hero Optima HX or Ola electric scooter. Here Hero Optima HX, I think they are offering around 130 kilometers of range, close to 130 kilometers of range in their Optima HX electric scooter with a price of below 80,000 rupees. Whereas Ola electric scooter, they are offering Ola S1 electric scooter, they are offering up to 121 km IDC range in 1 lakh pricing. Here Ola S1 is considered as a more featured electric scooter, whereas this Hero Optima HX electric scooter is a basic electric scooter which covers all your basic needs. So based on your requirement, whether you need the features, you can go with Ola S1. Or I need just for traveling purpose, I just want need some charging and I want to save the money. Below 80,000 rupees, you can go for Hero Optima HX. And the next question is asked by Mr. AJ. He is referring to the previous subscriber's question. By subsidy, the questionnaire means as the government gives subsidy only on one vehicle. If he buys one two-wheeler, will the government consider it one vehicle and not give him subsidy on car? Government means one vehicle in all category or separate categories? See, definitely government consider it can be an electric two-wheeler, three-wheeler or four-wheeler, they will consider as one vehicle. If he purchased already one electric two-wheeler which is eligible for subsidies, then he cannot be eligible for subsidy for another vehicle. So as simple as that, it can be electric two-wheeler or four-wheeler. If he purchased electric two-wheeler, later he is going to purchase electric four-wheeler, he will not be eligible for FAME II scheme subsidy. But there is one thing we need to look after, is the FAME II scheme document. In the FAME II scheme document, there is nowhere mentioned that the subsidy is eligible for only for one family. In that way, there is no point in the document. They have mentioned once per the user. For example, if they are family member, there is a husband and wife, definitely it should be eligible one vehicle for the wife and one vehicle for the husband. And the other family member also, grandfather and grandmother as well. Because subsidy is eligible for one person. It's not for one for family. That is clearly mentioned in the, there is no way mentioned in the document that it is only one for the family. It is one for the person. The next question is asked by Mr. Mahesh Chavan. My question is that if I want to increase the range of any scooter for X kilometers like Magnus Pro, but scooter range is only 80 kilometers. In future, suppose I want more kilometers. So he is saying that you want to extend the range of the battery. See, the extension of the battery pack is only possible if there is ample amount of space available in the boot space. Every company will design their electric vehicle based on the battery pack space, everything. Based on the battery pack length, everything, they will design the electric scooter. This 80 kilometer range, they will design particular boot space, everything. If the electric scooter you are referring to, if they are providing additional boot space, then there is a possibility you can buy additional battery pack and you can install in the boot space. But if there is only limited space available where you cannot put additional battery pack, it is not possible. So that's the answer for your question. And the next question is asked by Mr. Nitin Subdi. I asked about Ola subscription. Kindly cover in next question and answer. Yeah, we one of the subscribers asked this question to Ola customer care support, and they replied that there is no subscription charges additionally. It will be included in the eSIM card. That's what they replied to. And the next question is asked by Mr. Rohit Kumar. I have a doubt. What is the minimum drop in the range that is necessary to claim warranty in the 3-year period? If range drops by 20% or more, will they repair or replace the battery? See, this particular question is varies, depends on the company. Every electric vehicle company having their own terms and conditions on the battery pack warranty. Some company may say that after 20% of battery drop, that they will say like this. Some companies offering unlimited battery warranty. So it is purely depends on the battery pack company manufacturers or the companies who are selling the electric vehicle. And some people are saying 20,000 kilometers or 3 years, whichever comes earlier. So lot of terms and conditions depends on the companies. It's not about you simply say this company will give you this particular kilometer. So your question you can ask this particular electric vehicle company are saying this particular kilometers and terms and condition. Maybe we can answer that in a very clear way. So the range degradation or unlimited kilometers based on the company and the manufacturer. The next question is asked by Mr. Bishnu Mohan Behera. Will one battery after its life cycle can be able to charge or give output? See, for example, if the company promised 500 life cycles, even after the 500 life cycles, the battery will work, but it will not give the exact kilometer range what they have promised. For example, there will be a lot of range degradation. For example, they mentioned around 50 kilometers of range. Maybe you can get hardly 10 to 15 kilometers of range. So range will be degraded. After 600 life cycles, you can use this lithium ion battery as your power source, such as your inverter battery. So after a lifetime also, lithium ion batteries will work, but you can use these batteries as your home appliances power sources. That is the best way you can use this lithium ion batteries after this battery life cycle. The next question is asked by Mr. Melvin Matthew. How do we check quality cells? Any specific methods to check? See, so far it is quite difficult to check this quality of cells. Everybody, because lithium ion batteries comes with a complete sealed battery. Unless until if you want to really know the quality of these batteries, better to ask with the existing customers. Do you find any range drop in the batteries? Then you can come to a conclusion, okay, they are using some quality cells or some poor quality cells. That is the only way, because you cannot, because even the dealer don't have the right to open the battery pack. If there is a warranty issue, those battery packs should be sent to the manufacturer itself. If they open that, and it cannot be claimed under warranty. So that is the reason we cannot say that these batteries are good qualities of cells. The best way, ask the existing customers, okay, this battery is giving better range or any range drops is happening. In that way, you can get a conclusion. This company is offering good quality of cells. Next question is asked by Mr. Vishwanath Raju Kakani. We are missing an important update that some of EV companies have reduced their prices, one of them being Hero Electric. Ola S1 Pro 180 km range, 115 km top speed, other touch-up features. Hero Electric NVX HX dual battery, 165 km range, 50 km per hour top speed, practical, no touch-up features. I think most of the middle class people would prefer going for Hero Electric, as these touch-up features presently in Ola, such as stylish look, digital dashboard, acceleration, etc. are not so important to them. Moreover, we are getting it at almost half of the price. So one thing I just want to make a correction here. Hero Electric NVX HX dual battery, they claim to have 165 km range, but no dealer is telling to the customer it is giving 165 km. The maximum range they are giving is 120 to 130 km of range with the dual batteries. But at the same time, Ola S1 Pro also 180 km, it is practically, you can get up to 140 to 150 km of range. Now the important question is, it's about the value for money. Definitely, If you want to use this as a normal electric scooter just for your daily purposes, definitely go for a less cost and more value electric vehicle. It can be Hero Electric or Ampere vehicle, Thunwall, any other company. Based on the money, you can go for this Hero Electric scooter or any other electric scooter. Not just because more features offering, you should buy Ola electric scooter. Nobody is forcing to buy Ola or simple one electric scooter. It's purely the customer choice. Based on the value for money, anybody can proceed for the electric vehicle. But the main thing, always check for the service and also the spare parts. And the final question is asked by Mr. Zamzam Stores India. I am a pure EV customer waiting for this issue. He is referring to the recent fire accidents. If it is a manufacturing defect, then will Pure EV organization call back their EVs and rectify the issues? Definitely, not just Pure EV, any company, if they have any kind of issues happening in the battery pack, definitely they will send back the battery to their warehouse and they will repair the vehicle, and then they will repair the battery packs and they will send back to the customer. You don't need to worry about this. So these are some of the answers for subscriber questions. And if you have any questions about electric vehicles, please ask them with the hashtag #AskElectricVehicles, and we will answer the questions in the next episodes. For genuine information about electric vehicles, please do subscribe to our electric vehicle channel. And for faster updates, please do follow our Facebook page and website. Go green, go electric.